Hi, my name is Divya Bhaskaran and I'm a Senior Product Manager on the Windows team. Welcome to Windows 11 Release Notes for May 2024. Today, we show you how to control your PC using only your voice with, you guessed it, voice access in Windows 11. But first, let's get started with a look at what's new this month. This month's update features enhancements to widgets. In addition to improving the look of widgets icons on the taskbar, we are starting to roll out a larger set of animated icons. The experience with widgets on the lock screen is also improved with support for more visuals and customization. If settings stops responding when you dismiss a flyout menu, this update addresses that issue. And in the coming weeks, you might see your most frequently used apps appear in the recommended section of the start menu. Now let's talk about voice access in Windows 11 and how to use it. Voice access was introduced in the Windows 11 2022 update. With this powerful feature, you can use your voice to control your PC and author text. And because it is a part of Windows, you don't need an internet connection to use it. You can launch voice access using Windows Search or from Settings. In the Start menu, select Settings, Accessibility, Speech, and then turn on Voice Access. If you want to automatically launch Voice Access when you start your PC, select the box for Start Voice Access before you sign into your PC or Start Voice Access after you sign into your PC. Once you complete an initial setup with your microphone and preferred language, you are ready to use your voice to work with Windows and apps, the mouse, the keyboard, and items on the screen. Using voice access is simple and intuitive. For example, let's say you want to work with the nightlight feature in Windows. You can say, open settings, then click display or tap display. If there is more than one option, voice access will display numbers to help you choose the option you want. In this case, you say 1. Say, toggle night light to turn the night light on immediately, or say, click night light and then 1 to get to the night light settings. Once there, you can interact with the settings in multiple ways. You can say, move strength right 20 times to move the strength slider and increase the night light intensity. Or you can say, toggle schedule night light to turn scheduling on. Once you are done, you can say close settings to close the settings window. You can use voice access to interact with apps through familiar commands like open, close, switch to, minimize, maximize, and restore, and snap windows to specific spot on the screen. Once in an app window, you can use commands like click, double click, or scroll to interact with controls. To focus on an item, you can say move to or focus on, followed by the name of the item. Want to pause voice access? Simply say mute and voice access will go into sleep mode. Say voice access wake up to turn it back on again. There are hundreds of ways to use voice access to interact with apps, controls and overlays, and dictate text. Not sure how to perform the task you want? Simply say, what can I say, or show all commands for a list. Before we wrap up, I want to mention two more cool things about voice access in Windows 11. First, you can create custom voice shortcuts for single actions such as opening a link or multiple actions performed in a sequence. To get started, activate voice access and say, open voice shortcuts. On the voice shortcuts page, say, click create new shortcut to initiate the command creation. Give your shortcut a name, an action to perform, and assign it to a shortcut group if desired. Say click save to save your new shortcut. This feature is available in English for now. We will keep you updated as new languages are available. Second, in response to your feedback, you can now use voice access across multiple displays. Visit aka.ms/voice-access-multi-display to learn how. With so many ways to use voice access, you may be wondering, what's the best way to get started? Visit aka.ms/get-started-with-voice-access and use the voice access guide to learn and practice basic commands. You can also bring up the guide anytime if voice access is open by saying open voice access guide. Are there Windows 11 features you'd like to know more about? Share your feedback through our release notes page or leave a comment on our Windows Community YouTube channel at aka.ms/Windows Community on YouTube. That's it for this month. Thanks for watching.